here are the Brazilian twins, and my name is Wagner.
And my name is Walter.
Mm-hmm. Walter and Wagner in Portuguese. We all grew up in this very poor place in Rio de Janeiro.
Favelas.
Favelas, yeah. My dad, our dad, he's a violin maker. He literally forced us to learn how to play the violin, because even though he can make, he cannot play a note on the violin. People, we came from a neighborhood that people live in a place smaller than a toilet, a bathroom. In five families living in that place, you know, like very small, no windows, no glass, like houses made out of cardboard, pieces of wood that they put together to build a, you know. We start like, oh, learning music from the radio on our own. So then I played a song from the radio, and then another song. So now when I took the violin to my friends, like, hey, I can play. Look, I played a song that they knew, they related to it, and they're like, oh my God, this is awesome. Yeah.
So we start being accepted.
Accepted. So my first like fever with music was Backstreet Boys.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So immediately when I got crazy about Backstreet Boys, I came up with my own boy
dancing
boy
group.
Band. Yeah. Boy band, so I was AJ.
He's getting old.
Yeah, my first inspiration music related was definitely Backstreet Boys. That's when I like, okay, I start dancing, and then I start dreaming and dreaming more, and then Michael Jackson hit me really hard. I loved Michael Jackson.
That's when we start having fun with the violin.
Because now we can play anything on the radio in a matter of minutes. If we listen to a song, we can play right there. Like as soon as the song finishes, I can play the entire song.
We did a show in Brazil, viewed the interview, went to the NPR radio. We had no idea what the NPR radio was, and we didn't care. So we gave the interview. Somebody in Iowa heard the interview and decided to fly us all the way to Iowa to the World Food Prize.
Yeah.
They let us play one song. In this 2-minute show, the president of University of Northern Iowa in Cedar Falls, you and I, was there, watched the show, and invited us to be full ride scholarship at college. We went to Iowa. We had no idea what Iowa was like.
What you expect, nothing about the culture.
Yeah, we didn't have access back in Brazil. We didn't have access to the internet, computer, so we just literally came just for the hell of it, and here we are.
Yeah.
Years ago, I was living my life. Then I start feeling pain, these two fingers here. And I thought it was a pinched nerve that was gonna go away, you know. But what happened is that pain started getting worse and worse in a point that I could not handle anymore. So in this day, I was taking a shower, got out of the shower, and stood in front of the mirror with my beautiful body. And right in front of the mirror, I noticed a lump. Right here, like very easy to see. And then I took that to my doctor. Hey, I think I found the reason why my fingers hurt. And he immediately sent me to another doctor. And that's when this is cancer, and it's a very bad type of cancer. Even sarcoma. I did 9 months of radiation and chemotherapy. From the moment that I learned that I had cancer until the end of my treatment, I never dropped a tear. It was just joy. Cancer. I understand that we are here for just a matter of time, you know, and we are all gonna go. The end is it. we are gonna die. Don't matter how nice, how good, how beautiful, how strong, how skinny, rich. How rich, we are gonna die. And that's the way I found to deal with the reality, and also to give the news to my friend. Come on, people, I'm not the first one, or I will not be the last one to get cancer. And guess what? I'm gonna die, you are gonna die, everybody's gonna die, so what is the matter?
Hello everybody, I'm back with good news. Guess who is beating cancer? Yeah!
I learned a lot throughout my fight. I learned a lot. Four of the things that I learned is life is very short. You know, there you are, think you have plans for tomorrow, next week, and it changed really quick. Number two, fear is our worst enemy. So that, I strongly believe, was very helpful for me to lift fear aside. Number three, we all have a problem. So if you are sitting there, going through a weird time in your life, just as hard and as weird as it sounds, sit back and relax. You are not the only one. Number four, things could always get worse. Always get worse. A good example of that is that when I was in that room and they received the news that I had cancer, right at that moment I thought, oh damn, that's probably the worst news I ever got in my life until this point. 5 minutes later, the same doctor that gave the news that I had cancer came back into the room. By the way, we are gonna have to amputate your arm, my left arm. That's how severe the cancer was. Like, whoa! I was literally thinking about playing the trumpet. You know, yeah. Like I would have one arm left. I got this. So things could always get worse. I understand that we are here for just a split of a second. You know, life, oh, he's 85 years old, 85. It goes so fast. You know, if you talk, have a conversation with a 90 years old person, you'll see that The most common thing is like, oh man, it's so fast, life is so short. That's another thing also that we figured out a while ago. Helping, giving, laughing is contagious. Once you help somebody, you feel amazing about yourself. Once you give, giving is very good.
It's most of the time, if you pay attention, it's way more beneficial when you give than when you gain something.
Don't get us wrong, don't get us wrong. There are moments in our life that, you know, we get sad, we get frustrated. It's we are humans, you know? This is life. It's made out of ups and downs. And once you understand that it is made of up and down,
it's supposed to be like
this. It's supposed to be. Sadness will never last forever, just like happiness. You're not gonna be happy every single day until you die. No, it's a balance, and that's all we need, a balance.